Is it working? I think it's working. Holy moly. Yeah, we're having storms. Them suckers in the Gulf Coast sent their storms our way. And so we've flash flood warnings till Thursday are in effect here in the mountains. So let's I need your help. Where did I leave off as far as where did it quit? Does anyone know where it quit? You quit seeing or hearing me, and I'll pick up there. If you just type it in. Thanks, Eric. Thanks, James, for being here. Mario, David, I'm going to get to your questions in a minute. Do you know where I left off? I know what we were talking about. I just don't know where it quit. I was still talking. I looked over and that thing's flashing that there's nothing, no internet. Oh, okay. Now, let's do part two. Is perfect because part two is about the two loopholes. You ready for loophole one? It's not as effective, but it works. It's not as, the longevity of it is not as effective. Thanks for welcoming me back. Good day, Mick. Anyway, so here's the deal. Two loopholes for getting around that. And here's how that would work. One, just walk into a Home Depot or Lowe's and talk to the manager. Don't call them. Talk to them. Go in there maybe with a picture. Maybe on your phone, even if you don't have flyers or rack cards or any of that stuff. You just go in there with, hey, this is us. We'd love to come and serve your customers. Maybe I'm booked right now, but I can make be here next Thursday for lunch. That has gotten a lot of vendors into Lowe's and Home Depot, but sometimes a district manager will mosey around and see a vendor and go, oh, you're supposed to be at Street Eats. It's the awesome outfit we have that runs all our vendors so that there's no problems. And they'll verify everything. They don't verify nothing. So here's the deal. So they basically just get paid to do nothing. Okay. This is my opinion. Again, I'm saying this is my opinion. It's CYA, see. I'm CYA-ing. And I'm doing that because I don't want them going, oh, we did check on a vendor 22 years ago. We sent somebody by. Well, he was getting a light bulb at Lowe's anyway, and he saw the vendor, and he checked on him. They'll tell you you have to have uniforms and all this crap. So that's loophole one. Go into them. Talk to them. Hey, my name's Ben. My wife and I run a hot dog cart. We're busy as heck. Somebody suggested we set up here one day. How would you like it if we set up here? Do you notice how I worded that? I didn't say, can we please set up here in front of your store because you got lots of customers? You never say that. You say, hey, how would you like it if we came and served some of your customers? We might could fit you in next Thursday. You don't have to use Thursday. Just pick a date. And then you're going, but Ben, I want to vend more than just one day. Foot in the door. Foot in the door first, right? Instead of foot in the mouth. So you want to get in the door. Well, once you get in the door, if you're a good vendor and you followed the stuff that I teach at learnhotdogs.com, it's free, by the way, you do that, you're going to be a good vendor. You're going to get a good reputation. You're going to have more work than you know what to do with, right? So, and somebody asked me while I was gone, they actually messaged me and said, well, what about this vendor with the 300 locations or 300 events or over 300 events? I have asked him to do I'd asked him today. I emailed him and said, would you do a live interview? And I haven't heard back. So I'm waiting. Okay. Even if he'll write an article and pictures or, you know, co-write an article with me for the blog, anything, I'd take anything. Right. So here's the deal. Loophole number two. Some of you may not like this. Okay. But it works, and I'm going to put this up and just write this down for later. Just save it for later, okay? There it is. It's on the bottom of your screen right there under me, okay? That is a sales page. It's a sales page for a course I made. It's going to give you a lot more information than you need, but stay tuned. Don't get mad yet. Don't get mad and go, oh, my God, Ben's selling me something. Yes, that's how I make a living. But here's all you got to do. Okay, you go I'm going to give you a awesome tip, okay? An awesome one. So write this down and follow my instructions. Go to a local charity in your town, just a local charity. Not no Red Cross, not no BS big charity that gives 9% of what they take in. I'm talking not March of Dimes, not none of that crap. Go to a real charity. Maybe it's the battered women's shelter. Maybe it's the children's home. Maybe it's the drug abuse center. Maybe it's the Humane Society. Go to them and say, hey, my name's Ben. Of course, you fit your name in there instead of mine. And we have a cart that we run. It's licensed and insured anyway. We'd like to help y'all raise some money. And I promise, here's what they'll do. Oh my God, you would? And you go, yeah, we try to give back to different community groups and stuff, and we'd love to help you raise some money. And they'll go, well, what do we need to do? And say, nothing really. I just wanted to get your blessing that we could raise some money for you. And they may say, how much? And you go, well, we're going to give you a portion of proceeds. We're not sure where we're going to venge yet, but we're going to take a portion of the proceeds from that day or that week or that month or that year and give to you. Okay? And they go, oh, that sounds good. Well, while we're here, do y'all have any signs or anything with your logo? Do you have any t-shirts? I'd only need a couple shirts. Do you have any of that stuff? Oh, yeah, we'll give you Humane Society shirts, save a dog, you know, ride a cowboy, something like that. Anyway, it would have that. So you now have some clout. Now imagine this. You walk into Lowe's. Hi, Manager Rick. My name's Ben. And my wife and I run a small hot dog cart, and that's how we provide for our family. But we're trying to raise some money for the local Humane Society. We talked to Beth up there, and we wanted to see if it was okay if you'd like us to serve here and raise some money for them. And they'll be like, oh, now think about this. They're going to feel like assholes if they don't let you. I've never had anybody say no, ever. In fact, I got into a freaking courthouse, okay, front steps courthouse, okay, with this same deal by saying this. Yeah, we're hoping the radio station, we're talking to them, and hopefully they'll pick us up, or the local newspaper, you know, the Mountain Press, we're hoping they'll pick this up. And now they go, oh, crap. So he's working with the battered wives shelter, raising money for them. He's already talked to the newspaper, the Mountain Press. Oh, of course, you can vent here. Absolutely. Have a good time. Okay, that's in that course. I go way deeper. I give you some things to watch out for and all kinds of other things you can do. Okay? It's a way to get in any location you want. Like, we have vendors that are working federal courthouses. We have vendors working behind the scenes at the White House. No crap. If I had it here, I'd show you. I have a vendor there, and he got me a president's whatever Secret Service badge and whatever. I got a badge. I got the tie emblem and everything. The official crap. It made me happy. I showed it on here one time, but I didn't tell the story behind it. So bottom line is, that's how you get into Lowe's or Home Depot without going through Street Eats. But if you want the information on Street Eats and just learn about it, I've given you fair warning, and I put in the comments a direct link to their site, okay? They've changed their name to something different. It's called Better Vendors or Better something. I'll tell you what it is. It's bestvendors.com/street-eats/again. That is in the little information box below. So now you have a direct link to them if you want to try to get in through their doors to one of those locations. Okay? I don't like paying somebody for a location. I think that's ridiculous. There's my 2 cents on that. Now, I think I covered everything there. Oh, well, let me just tell you this. People think Lowe's and Home Depot are the end-all, be-all. BS. They're not. They're not. Yes, there are some really busy ones, but you don't care if they're busy all day. You care if they're busy from 11 to 1, because that's when you want to be there. You don't want to be there all day, okay? Because people ain't eating hot dogs at 10 in the morning typically. You might sell 2, but you ain't going to sell 10. You ain't going to sell 100, 200. I want to sell 100 hot dogs or 100 meals between 11 and 1 or 11 and 2. I want to be there when the contractors are coming and going. And I don't want to be there every day, because guess what? People ain't there every day. It ain't always busy at Home Depot or Lowe's. Have you been in there sometimes? I mean, it's like a freaking ghost town sometimes in there. So, and I've been to multiple ones. I'm a well-traveled Lowe's and Home Depotian. Okay, so that gives you that. Let me pull this up for you. I need to read some of these real quick. Just bear with me. And if you have any questions about this, put them in the comments on the chat here, and I'm going to try to get to those real quick in a minute. Okay? Check this out. Almost World Famous Hot Dogs and Catering. This is one of the people watching the show and hasn't started yet. Sorry I missed the live feed. Haynes, Alaska here. He's in Haynes, Alaska. We have a vendor in Alaska at a federal courthouse with my locations course, which is federal courthouse. Okay. Our last census was 1374 souls, not what you would call a metropolis. He's talking about the, you know, we talked about the small towns yesterday. 2 permanent restaurants in town, both selling out. Opportunity knocks. The summer season, typically about 12 weeks, sees tens of thousands of people coming through town for various reasons. Cruise ships once or twice a week, fishing, travelers from Canada and continental U.S., several small community festivals in and out of season. We have seen the Southeast Alaska State Fair, which draws quite a crowd for a few thousand over a period of 4 days. There are no fast food restaurants, no big box stores, a few seasonal vendors, but in the 16 years I've lived here, I've never seen a hot dog sold in any of them. Just got your book a few days ago. By the way, learnhotdogs.com/book if you're looking for the book. That's the course book. It's not something that's, it's not like a story tale. It's a course book. It'll get you started and on the right path. It's less than 10 bucks. Okay. That other one, the location course, is pretty expensive. It's cheaper than it normally is, but I mean, it's about a third of what it normally is right now. But it's still expensive. Okay. And don't get that yet unless you're already vending. Don't get the any location course unless you're already vending, because you don't need it yet. Okay. Let me finish reading this. Due diligence first. Absolutely. Almost World Famous Hot Dogs and Catering. Thank you for the comment. Big Papa Bear. Small towns can be done, but I would go to where the money is. My hometown has about 2,000 people, a concrete plant, and also a food plant, but people here are cheap. I have several vendors have tried and didn't make the past 2 months. A local JC's have a monopoly on the parks and local businesses, give away free hot dogs, chips, and pops every summer. $2 to $3 hot dogs will never work here, in my opinion. I know a few other who do vend hot dogs in other towns, but they only charge a dollar. Do your research, folks. Absolutely, you got to look at the economics, but I have to disagree with him as far as which locations, because if you serve a quality product and you educate your consumer and you can actually go to these places that are already giving them away, do you think that's fun for them or easy for them to set up hot dog giveaways? No, they'd rather somebody else do it. It's why somebody comes and cleans their septic tank out, because they don't want to do it themselves, right? So what they do is they hire people, but there's nobody to hire. So they hire you. We have vendors right now that's all they do is do car lots, and they get paid to be there, and they get a guaranteed amount every week. One of them's in my book, and that's old, and he's still doing it, okay? So he gets all of his hot dogs paid. I show you that in the book. All his hot dogs are paid, okay? And then the dealership pays for those hot dogs, so he gets double paid for his hot dogs. If you're following me here, he gets his hot dogs for free, and then he sells them to the dealer. The dealer, and I'll tell you the dealer is, it's Jim Cogdell Dodge in Knoxville, Tennessee. Anyway, that's just one. All of them do this stuff, or all of them would do it if they knew about it. So you just got to educate people about it. You just go in, hi, talk to them. Hey, do y'all do a customer appreciation? Oh, absolutely, we do a customer appreciation every Friday. Well, why? So these types of locations, these things, are way better than a Lowe's and Home Depot. There are some Lowe's and Home Depots that do extremely well that are awesome. How many are you going to run through to try before you find one that really is good, that gets more than 100 people at lunch? Because if 100 people come in between 11 and 1 at your Lowe's, That's pretty good, but they ain't all buying. So you need about 500 people coming in between 11 and 1 so that you can sell 100 meals. That's how that works. Big Papa Bear, don't take offense to my comment. I just have, I'm in touch with thousands of vendors, and I would tend to disagree. I've had vendors tell me this area just won't make it. This area won't do it. Had John Cavanaugh, personal friend of mine. He became a friend through vending. He found me, found the book, and started vending, right? His town, the town sucks, right? Town sucks. Nobody's buying these hot dogs. Nobody's going to spend money on this. Nobody, nobody, nobody. He goes to the farmer's market, sets up, and does over $5,000 in 2 days at a farmer's market. And he did that since then until he died of cancer just a year and a half ago. We raised money for his wife because she needed money. Anyway, ice cream lady, kind of like doctors get... Okay, she's talking about the weather. Let's see. Oh, let me read this. This is from Ice Cream Lady Driver. Haven't heard from her in a while. This is cool. I've been dreaming of setting up at the lake for years. Well, I did it. Saturday, I sold a whopping 2 lemonades and 2 pretzels, and the place was packed Memorial Day. I sold 44 worth of pretzels, ice cream, 4 cupcakes, and 1 lemonade. That sucks. I mean, that sucks. I invested $818 between the lemon smasher and the compressor. Now, I was informed that they're letting a lady come in who will be selling hot dogs and lemonade that has a cute little trailer and looks like a lemon. I've seen them. Okay. You can beat them. I'll show you how. This is why they let me add ice cream. I'm not happy at this time and want to pull out and try something else, but my husband thinks I need to give it a try. I agree with your husband. And you know what? I know enough about you because you've emailed me pictures and everything. Okay. That you're not a quitter, you're not a, I'm going to try something else. You're a lady who's built, what, 4 carts now? Yourself, trailers? 3 or 4? I don't believe you. I don't believe you'll leave that. I don't believe that's the right decision. I don't believe you'll do it. I believe you'll come to your senses and your husband's right. Okay? You're made different. You're not a quitter. My concern is that once this other lady comes in, I won't be able to get my trailer out. Oh yeah, I'm right next to a shaved ice shack. They had a line about 20 or so minutes on Saturday. Lemonade is something we have to educate people on. Well, no. No, you shouldn't have to educate people on lemonade. If you're having to, you are in the wrong location. But here's the thing. It depends on presentation. I would want to see the presentation. Because if you look, and you know this, okay, you know this. Ice cream lady driver, you know, you've got like Ken Packer, okay? Ken Packer, Packer's Lemonade, okay? In Tennessee. You know you've got Warren Russell, Podunkville. I'm talking 3 people in his whole town, and 2 of them are cats. So, and makes a killing. Not educating people, it's presentation. Big 32-ounce cups and all this stuff, right? I would have to see more. I'd have to see a picture of your setup from a distance so that I can see what they're seeing, what the customer's seeing that's preventing them from coming up. I hate that you did sucky at this event. That sucks. But you and I both know there's bad days in vending. You've vended long enough to know that. And sometimes there's no rhyme or reason. Okay, how much is shipping? Can you get financing? Same person. T151. Can I get financing? Top of every page on our site. Hotdogcartstore.com. How much is shipping? Top of every page on our site. Shipping cost. Link on every page on the site. Hotdogcartstore.com. But thanks for the question. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Very good motivation video. Chat Town Dogs coming soon to Chattanooga, Tennessee. That's who I was trying to think of a minute ago. That's who made the video. I shared the video a minute ago in the comments on the last one. You know what? I'm going to try to share that again just so that it's here too. Maybe if I can get it to work. Bup, 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 bup. Bear with me, bear with me, bear with me. Got it. Copy. And now I'm going to come back over here and put paste in the... Oh, where is that? That's a different place. I'm at the wrong place. Okay. So there we go. I just sent that there. Watch that video. If you want to feel good before you go to bed tonight, watch that video. You'll feel good. It'll hit you in the feels, I promise. Okay, so, or your money back. Remember, money back guarantee. Let's see. Now, let's go to the comments. Holy moly, roly poly. Okay, David's in the house. Scott the Sarge is in the house. James Smith is in and out. David Young, at least he didn't have his eyes closed and mouth open. Absolutely. He said that because David said he looks drunk. I look drunk. And maybe the hat. The hat makes anybody look drunk. How about this? Still looking. Test 1, 2, 3, Dragon Winter, deer in the headlights look. Bitter beer face. No, don't do beer. Home Depot hacked Ben, probably. Haw Street Eats must have found him. Are they from Russia? Could be. Okay, I'm going to try to get down to any questions. I hope I didn't miss your questions from the last one because I can't see those now. Okay. Yep, it says no one's watching. Blah, blah, blah. I'm coming. I put James Smith in the house. Eric Von Dumb's in the house. Morgan Crowley. He is very nice and kind man that will bust his butt to see you do good. You are not going to find someone like him at other cart builders. Can't wait till my new cart gets here. Let me be honest. I know most of the long-term manufacturers out there, most of them are awesome. Let me give you an example. Mark, who owns Dreammakers. We have nothing to do with each other. We're competitors. But I know him. He knows me. We talk every now and then. And he is as good as gold, honest as the day is long, and builds an exceptional cart. Like a Cadillac of carts. Okay? So, I appreciate the kind words. And yes, I'd love the business. But I'm not the only one. Okay? And by the way, Petty, I want to thank you for reminding me where I was when I started back on this one. You left by saying Street said vendor was circumventing the system. Yeah, he said he was circumventing the system because he's negotiating the price. They gave him a price. He didn't like it. I don't blame him. They always start high and you got to work them down. But now they've come out with this. You're trying to circumvent the system. We have a system where we take your money, we do nothing, and then how dare you try to take some of that money back. Or get a discount from what we're taking from you. Hey Ben, what size trailer is ideal to build your own cart? It depends on what you want to build. Typically, you know, the smaller the better. You know, like a 40 inch, if you're buying a trailer kit, 40 inch, maybe by 5 foot, maybe a 40 by 48, 40 wide, and that's frame to frame. If you count the wheels and hubs on the little 8-inch wheels all the way to the outside of each one, you're looking at 54 inches wide, finished with, you know, fenders. Menards. I do not think they do Menards, but I could be wrong. I did find out, though, Street Eats, Best Vendors, is owned by a company called Compass Group. Compass Group is from the United Kingdom. So they're not even in the United States, yet they're managing Lowe's and Home Depot's for the United States. I'm done ranting on that. That's my 2 cents on that. More questions here. What do you do in a town with no foot traffic? You find out how the heck they're getting everything. Like, how do they go into a parts store? How do they go to their job, you know, are they pulling up in cars like it's a drive-in job? You drive in, you sit in your car, and you work all day. I'd like to know what you mean by, I'm not trying to be an asshole, but I'm trying to figure out what do you mean no foot traffic? Because there's places where people gather, and people love outdoors. Even in the winter, people will brave the outdoors. We have vendors who are in Alaska who work year-round, which is crazy to me. Because Alaska has days where they never see the sun type deal. They have these weird long days and weird long nights, and they got some weird days. James says, if you don't have Hot Dog Save My Life, get it ASAP. That is my course book, and I thank you for that plug, James. Hey, Ben, keep the videos coming. You are the man. No car yet, but I will get there. Take your time. There is no rush. People have been doing this for hundreds of years, literally. Okay, they've been vending. We know of vendors that have been vending, not like they're alive, but we know of vending. Street food vending has been around for eons. Okay? I saw the first vendor and in color, you know, on TV on the Flintstones. So I know they were vending back then. That's a long time ago. Waiting on my inspection, but I got out at night. Did some factories make money in the meantime? Absolutely. Absolutely, Mike. DCB Concessions in the house. Cheryl Bridges is here. Thanks for being here, Cheryl. Morgan Crowley. Hey, Ben from Missouri. Absolutely, Morgan. I was talking about John Cavanaugh. He's from Springfield, Missouri. I can't hardly wait till next month. June is going to be an exciting month for me and the wife. I can't wait for you either, Broccoli Hard. I think that is freaking awesome. Tom says, my sound is low and I can't hear you. I did turn it down, but I turned it down because people said I was too loud. Everybody hear me okay? Life gave us lemons, and I love this name for a company. Artie Rodriguez. Life gave us lemons and catering. That's the name of the company. Life gave us lemons and catering. And I love that. He's in Lockahatchie, Florida. Lockahatchie, Florida. Michael Grosso. Hey, Ben. Mike's Big Dogs and more catering coming real soon. Michael, I will be behind you. I promise I will be your cheerleader. Hey, Ben from Castro's Dogs, update coming soon. Y'all remember Castro's Dogs? Did y'all see do you remember the vendor that I got the pleasure to, interview recently, who has schizophrenia? Him and his wife were in it, and their 800 kids were running behind them in the video. They have an awesome family. They're awesome people, big hearts, great people. He's here in the comments right now, and he's going to have an update coming soon. When we interviewed him, he had been vending 7 days or 8 days at the time. If you haven't seen that video, it's here. It's free, okay? Broccoli Heart says it's low. I have no idea why it's low. I can try to turn it up. Hold on just a second. Bear with me just a second. I'm going to try to turn this up a little bit and see if, how is it now? Is that better? I know it's not immediate. There's a delay. Any tips on anticipating crowds for supplies on lemonade for first time events and outings? You know what, Jason, this is a great question. It's one of the most asked questions. It's in my top 10 list because it doesn't matter if it's lemonade or if it's hot dogs. It's always a great question because you go, how much do I take? How do you know what to take? Take what you can afford to take that wouldn't make you broke if you didn't sell it, and that you have a place to store in the event you didn't sell it. Don't go out and hawk all your credit cards and sell three of your dogs and two of your kids' kidneys to get enough lemons to go vend. Don't do that. Don't risk. Go with just enough that you feel comfortable in risking, okay? And then if you sell out early, yeah, you may kick your butt on the way home and go, damn, I could have made another $1,000. Who cares? You sold out. Pat yourself on the back. Go home. Celebrate. Uncrinkle $1 bills and $5 bills and $20 bills and $10 bills and celebrate with the wife or the husband and the dogs. Okay? That's what you do. I never worry about that. Now, when you start doing big events, then you need to take some planning. We use factors. We take factors of how many other vendors are going to be there. We always look at where they're going to put us. I have a complete thing on that. It's free. At learnhotdogs.com, just type in the word events, and it will give you a ton of information for determining how much product to take, especially what to expect, because you can really get in trouble with events. I talked about that a minute ago in the first part of this video, the video before this video, before my power quit. Thanks for answering my question. Almost done with your book. And Lord willing, I will be building my own cart soon. Thanks for everything you do. This is Jim85. Thank you, Jim. I appreciate it. I plan on adding under the logo, and we make lemonades. What you think? I like that. I like it. Any tips on anticipation? Okay, I did that one. I'm just making sure. Sounds great to me. I hear you fine. Volume sounds good. Sounds been fine for me for a while now. Thanks. Sounds fine here. Love it. Thanks. Sounds good. Booyah. I think we made it through this. This has been a long night. This is 30 minutes. The first one was like 15 or so. I love you. I want you to succeed. Know this. Force yourself to do exceptional things daily. Like if you hate reading, make yourself go read two blog articles, even if it has nothing to do with this. Maybe you want to be into that cryptocurrency stuff. Go read about it. Read about it. Educate yourself. Make progress, forward steps every day. And one day, you know, 6 months from now, you'll be looking back and going, dang, I got like a mini degree in this now. You will get better and better, and your life will get better and better because you're adding to the value of your own knowledge, your own experience in life. Do those things and you'll be successful. Also, follow what you like doing. Some people get into hot dog vending. I never dreamed of being a hot dog vendor. It wasn't like my all-time dream. Oh, God, I'm going to be a hot dog vendor when I grow up. I wasn't like that. That was the vendor the other day, though, that we did an interview on Hero Life. That was his dream since he was 9. He wanted to be a hot dog vendor. I think that's freaking awesome. It wasn't my dream, okay? And so this may be a stepping stool to something else. This may be something that provides freedom and income that you haven't experienced before, or you experienced the income, but it was at the cost of all your freedom. So you get them both. And then now you get freedom and income, and it's what gives you the time to pursue that writing a book or your painting or whatever passion you have in life. That's what it does for you. That's what it does, is it gives you that. And some people will take it and go crazy with it, like John Kavanaugh or Corey Lawrence or Jason Brown or Michael Wood. They keep growing and growing and growing, and they get bigger and bigger. And they didn't. Jason Brown was a police officer. He was a canine cop. He was a state trooper, I believe, and got hit by a drunk driver and ended that career. And hot dogs came in. And vending came in, and now he helps me teach other people. He's brilliant, brilliant dude. And he'll probably stay in it. He'll probably stay in it. Not that it's what his all-time ever favorite dream was. It's providing an income. He told me that last year, I'm not going to tell you what he made because I don't have permission, but I know what he made. And I went up and worked with him, you know, several times last year. But he averaged a little less than 4 days a week. If you took his average, 4 days a week. Okay. Well, there's 7 days in a week, right? And so his average for the year was a little less than 4 days a week. That's not bad. Every freaking week. That's like a third of your year off. Not bad. He's fixing to go into busy season and take a week or two and go to the beach with his family. And he's taking friends and extended family. There's a value in all this. And I hope you see it. And I hope that it encourages you and inspires you. And maybe it's not even freaking hot dogs. Maybe it's not lemonade. Maybe it's something that inspires you to chase after something that is more than creating a job or creating a job for yourself or creating or working for someone else where you're at their mercy. I wish you well. I love you. Hope you have a great night. And thanks for listening to me drone on about Home Depot and Lowe's, but I had to do